My day typically starts at about 5 a.m. First I have my bath, followed by my morning prayers, which takes about 15 to 20 minutes. Then I change, and then my bag is typically packed overnight with my gym clothes changed as well as the working clothes. I leave home at about 5:45 in the morning, and depends on the day and the schedule, we have the morning routine, maybe an hour or two. After that, I go to Bombay gym, and then shower, change, and office by 9:30 in the morning. Both my parents are diabetic. Way back in 1998, Dr. Shashank Joshi said that because of DNA or hereditary, diabetes to you is inevitable, and by the time you turn 40, I'm sure that you will be a diabetic. And that's when I started getting up early, going to a gym, started doing the rounds. That's when I realized it's important to be fit. As we age, any skill-based games after the age of 35, your reflexes slow down. The second issue is also that when you travel, and people like, obviously, kind of our work schedule, we are always on the move. When you travel, it's very difficult to find a gym, difficult to find a partner or a court to play any skill-based game. But running is just in a pair of shoes and socks. Get up in the morning, get in love with the city, discover the city, romance the city. Go for a morning, early morning run, and the city adopts you. Most importantly, what happens in running is that, especially if you are doing a 21, you may be doing a 10 kilometer or a 42 kilometer, the last 2 kilometers are the toughest, whatever may be the distance. Similarly, when you set a target of achievement numbers, 80% you will achieve, last 20% is a struggle. And to overcome that struggle, the physical running teaches you that it is possible. Draw up all your resources to make it possible. The same learnings translates to work life, saying that draw all your resources, think out of the box, and get those 20% number. I've been into some form of fitness very early on in life, but what running has done, it has intensified it, it has earned me a certain kind of social clout, and which is extremely different from my workplace. And this alternate community, which I have a sense of belonging to, is very precious to me, because that community and my attachment to that community is unconditional. Life is all about investment. You need to invest something for your body, something for your mind, and something for your soul. You want to succeed in life? Mind, intellect. You will obviously study hard, you will work hard for the mind. But freshness of the mind and ideation comes from what we call a healthy body. And for your soul, a meditation, especially in a digital age, you need some kind of digital de-addiction. Spend that 15 minutes, spend that 30 minutes with yourself without any digital screen. So body, mind and soul, every day, what have you invested about? Just ask yourself. If something is wrong, fix it.